Let's revise whatever done in the last class. So in the last class we have seen the smart mobility, right? So this smart mobility is specially related to the transport system, right? So how we can make the transport system more efficient or more comfortable for us, right? So right, so main aim of the smart mobility is to reduce the traffic and to enhance or to make the faster, greener and cheaper transportation, right? And provide or to create the maximum number of option for transportation, right? Okay, my screen is visible. Anybody can give the feedback? My screen is visible?
Yes.
Okay, so, right, so in smart mobility, we can include some services, right, like mode mobility on demand, mass mobility as a service, then public transportation, drones, the smart services in the freight and logistic, some autonomous transport systems, right? Car sharing scheme, some technologies like GPS, GPRS, or other kind of sensor, right? So that we have seen some key principles of smart mobility. We have seen like the main aim of smart mobility to make the transportation flexible, efficient, integrate, make them like clean, and which will provide safety, right? So flexibility by the mean like you will have the multi-mode transportation option, right? So like you provide a single platform, in that one can do the reservation or can do the payment, can track the vehicle, right? So all those facilities we can use through one platform, and the transport options are also more, right? The efficient, so like one can reach to the destination, right, without disturbance, without traffic, right, and the minimum time. Then integration, so like a full route is planned door to door, right? Regardless which type of transportation one has choose, right? So that is an integration. Then clean clean technology, so like we can use the vehicle in which we can reduce the air pollution, right? Then safety, so like you have some facility, so you a driver can get the information regarding to some incident or some thing, like they can avoid the accident or some injuries like that, right? And whatever option we are providing, right, all the option have like they are affordable for the people, right? We have seen, then we have seen some challenges in smart mobility, right? We have discussed some example or some solution of smart mobility, right? So this solutions, like we are working on that, some we already implemented, some still we are working to implement, right, in some foreign countries. Some solution are already they have implemented, right? Like the platform where like when company is providing the e-scooter, like you can use them on the rent, right? Whenever you want to use, you can take them, you will go to your destination, and again then you will put it, and whatever the distance you have traveled, right, based on that you will pay the rent, right? So that way you can use e-scooter, right? Also the scheme or some companies like they are created the platform which like you can register. If you are you have a car, then you can register, and whenever you are free or you are going to somewhere, then at that time you can open the portal, so some other can know like you are going on that route, on that path, or in the on that route. So if they want to go, they will hire you, or they will ask you for the ride, and you will provide them the ride. They will pay you, and like that way, another person can reach to that his destination with less money, and for you also, like if you both individually will go by the different car, then definitely the fuel consumption is double, right? Here two people reach to the destination with same amount or single usage of the fuel, right? So these are some mobility option solutions, right? Also, like we have discussed the time, I tell you some example, like some app, some projects, some platform, some software name, right? So next is the smart meter, right? So like from name we can understand what is smart meter, or and also like when we heard about the smart meter in our mic in our mind, the meter will like we will think about the meter which will use to measure the power consumption, right, at our home. So generally whenever we think about smart meter or we heard about the smart meter, first thing that will come in our mind, that is the meter which is used to measure the power consumption, or which is used to measure the energy consumption, right? So that is right, the smart meter is related to that, right? But not only for electricity measurement, right? Using that we can also do some other measurement. So if we'll specifically talk about that, what nowadays we are doing, right, what is in the practice, like at your home, whatever, like you have the electricity from the electricity supplier, generally government body, right? So you will take electricity from them. So when they will give you that electricity, they will give you through a meter. Say they will place a meter outside of your house, right? So after end of 1 or 2 months, they will one person will come to your home. He will read the reading in the meter, like how generally in India, right? They will measure that unit in the like how much unit you have used, right? So based on that they will create the bill, and you have to pay the bill, right? So for that you like one person has to come from the authority at your home, and after that they will create the bill, right? Also like in that traditional energy meter, you are not able to know like what is the power consumption right now, right? Like you can't know at particular this day how much power conserve on this day, how much power conserve, right? So that way you can't do the analysis, you can't know that data, right? So that is a kind of a hectic thing, right? So in some country like the electrical power supply, right, they have started to use the smart meter, right? So the smart meter is very similar to the our traditional energy meter, right, which is a block which we have at our home, right? So that will measure and the record the energy consumption data, right? This smart meter is somewhat different, right? But it has the ability, like it is a digital device that can communicate remotely with electricity supplier. So that meter have like ability, whatever data they will record, right? They will send the data to their supplier, right? Remotely, using some technology, using some communication protocol, right? So this smart meter will send the energy consumption information to supplier, like after every 15 minutes or sometimes like the way they have make the setting, right? So based on that, your meter will send the data, your meter will send the energy consumption information to supplier after like every 15 minute interval or some 1 hour interval, right? And because of that, it will eliminate the need of a person which will come to your home for reading, right? So they will remove that need of meter reader. So we can define smart meter as a electronics device that records the information such as consumption of electricity, voltage level, current, and the power factor, right? And the smart meter communicates the information to the consumer for greater clarity of the consumption behavior and electrical supplier for the system. So the meter can, like most of the time they will communicate with the supplier only, right? But it is possible, like on smart meter they have a display kind of thing in which you can see like whatever power is conserved today, or like starting from this date to this date what power is conserved, or sometimes like your supplier will send the data to you, right? Smart meter will send data to the supplier, electricity supplier, and they will send data to you. And this data, this information, right? So it will use by the consumer, like the data will provide the clarity, like what is the behavior of the power consumption at their home, right? And the supplier, they will use the data for monitoring and the customer billing, right? So one thing they will do is billing, and the second thing, like if such kind of system they will develop, then if some power failure will happen or some problem will happen, then they can know like this meter is not working or this meter is not sending data, means there is some problem. So that way they can come to know about the problem, so they can immediately go to that place or go to that house and they will solve the problem. Smart meters typically record the energy near real time and report regularly with the short interval throughout the day, right? Then the smart meter is often referred to an electricity meter, right? So generally, as I told, when you heard about the smart meter, you will relate it with the electricity meter. But that is not always true. The smart meter can be used as a measuring device for like natural gas, water, right? Or some distinct heating consumption. So like nowadays also we know we have the gas pipeline, right? So that also every month or after 2 months they will come to our home and they will give us the bill, right? So for that also they will have a meter kind of thing, right? Similar way we have not problem of water, right? So we have like government is supplying water like freely, but in some country like where it is not a free, right? So they will supply the water, and for that also they have a meter, like how much water you consume, right? So based on that they will provide the bill. So in such all kind of system, right, you have the smart meter, right, to measure the electricity, to measure the power consumption, to measure the usage of gas, to measure the how much water you have used, right? So smart meter usually involve the real time or near real time sensors power outage notification and power quality monitoring. So main task performed by the smart meter are like they have real time sensor, so they will measure the parameter, right, like how much quantity you have used. They will send the data. They will also provide the notification for power outage, right? So if some problem will happen, then they will send the notification to the supplier. Also, they will do the power quality monitoring, like we can monitor like on this day or on which day we have consumed more power, so that by that we can came to know like using these appliances, or it will like do this kind of thing, or we have some function, then that much of energy consumed on that day, right? So that way you can do the monitoring, right, of power. These additional features are more than the simple automated meter reading, right? So in smart meter there is a kind of meter which are known as automated meter reading, right? So in that they are not having that much of feature, right? Like they will send the notification, they will send the data, they will monitor the power quality, right? So this kind of feature, right, make them like similar to the advanced metering infrastructure, right? So these meters are similar to this advanced metering infrastructure meters, right? So in addition to reporting the energy usage, right, this meter can also inform the electricity supplier immediately if there is a power outage or so some problem happen, right, in some area. So such kind of facilities provided by like in Texas, right, whatever their electricity supplier, right? So they provide, they are using the smart meter, and in that they are providing this kind of feature. So that is the Texas smart meter, right? So they have that facility of sending the notification to supplier about the power outage. Then so because of that, like if such kind of facility, such kind of feature, if your meter will have, then once they will receive the notification, right, the supplier can quickly send the technical person or crew to resolve the problem, right? And again, like you will get the power back, right? That is as soon as possible. And once like the power is back, right, so everything is in the normal condition, then the smart meter will notify the electricity supplier of the resolution, right? So these smart meters enables two-way communication between the meter and the central system. So the central system is generally the electricity supplier, right? Or if your smart meter is for gas, then gas supplier. If it is for water, then water supplier. So this communication from meter to the network, right? It may be wireless, it may be wired, right? So both ways it's possible. If it's wire, then it will use some power line carrier, right? So it's a kind of wire they will use. And if it is wireless, then there is a many option, right, for the wireless technology. So wireless communication options include cellular communication, like whatever we are using for our mobile phone, right? So that kind of 2G, 3G, that can be used. We can use Wi-Fi, right? We can use wireless ad hoc networks or Wi-Fi. We can use wireless mesh network. We can use LoRa, so that have the feature of low power, long range wireless technology, right? Then we can use WISE, so that have the feature of high radio penetration rate, that is open source, or we can say open standard, and that is using the frequency of 169 megahertz, right? Also we can use Zigbee, right? That is having the feature of low power, low data rate and wireless, right? And we can also use the Wi-SUN, right? So Wi smart utility network, right? So these are some wireless communication protocol, communication technology which we can use in the smart meter, right? So depends on like which is comfortable, which is more suitable for the area or for the region in which you are want to implement this smart meter. So every this communication protocol have their own limitation, like some have the limited range. So you have to put like if you are using Wi-Fi, then you have to put a router kind of thing which is nearer to the like the meter, right? So your smart meter first send the data to your router, and through router the data will go to like the internet, or maybe using some other like cellular communication it will reach to their supplier, right? So how or which technology you are using, based on that you have to create the network, okay? Now how this smart meter will save energy, so one of the biggest benefit of smart meter for consumer is their ability to track the energy usage. So the most of the smart meters will come with display, right? Digital display, and they will like providing the information regarding the energy use, right? Though this reading, right, this whatever the information displayed on the display, right, it will not tell us like what is using the most electricity in our home. Like at the same time we are using more than one appliance, right? So which device or which appliance is using more energy, that thing we can't know through this reading, right? But it will make us aware like how much energy is used, and like day by day, or in some like previous month or some other month, right? So by knowing that, it can guide us to make the improvement, right? So you can do some improvement, like if you use these appliances, then your reading is more, so it is using more power, right? So that way you can reduce your electricity usage, and that way you can reduce your bill, right? So that way you can save the money. Some state government or utilities, means the supplier, even offer the online programs that allow you to track your energy consumption data, right? So not in India, but in foreign country, some government or some private electricity supplier board, right? So they will offer some online programs. So in that, if you join them, then they will give you the information about this energy consumption data, right? So such kind of feature or such kind of facility, right, that is provided by the Texas electricity supplier. So the Texas government offers a program called Smart Meter Texas, right? So the program name Smart Meter Texas, which allows the resident and the business customer to track the energy consumption data in 15 minute interval, as well as monthly and daily usage information, right? So this program will provide the information to resident, means to individual, or if you have some company or some offices, right? Some malls. So for that, those the customer also, they will like provide you the information about the energy consumption, like in every 15 minute interval, or also you can know by day wise, you can also know that month wise, right? Or maybe year wise, right? So that way it will provide the all the information. So using that you can do the analysis, and we will try to reduce the energy usage, right? So if we want to modify our energy use, we should be able to see how the changes play into our overall energy consumption each day and over the course of the month, right? So by knowing all these data, we can modify our energy use, and that way we can save the money. So these are some example. You can see I have also shown you the picture of the smart meter, right? So this is a smart meter based on Open Smart Grid Protocol, right? OSGP. In use in Europe. So in Europe, this kind of meter is used. Smart meter is used, right? There, and it has the ability to reduce the load, disconnect or reconnect remotely, and interface to the gas and water meter. So this single meter can be used for multi-purpose, like for electricity, for gas, for water, right? And they have ability to disconnect or reconnect remotely, right? So for example, you have not paid the bill of the last month, then nowadays in India, like one person from the electricity board will come. He will ask you like when you will pay, right? So that way they will come 2-3 times and still you will not pay, then they will cut the electricity supply, right? So for that, one person has to come to your home. But in such smart meter, like from remotely, you can disconnect, right? So you have to definitely pay the bill, right? If for example this kind of meter is used for example water meter, right, then like if they will found like they have limited water, then they will, what they will they do, they will reduce the like the flow, or they will supply the water such a way that it will reach to the all people, right? Otherwise what happens, somebody will use more and somebody will not get enough water, right? So that way the smart meter will help. Then the second example is you can see that is the smart meter which is provided by DT Energy, right? So it's a company in US, right? The electricity supplier in US, right? So they have also used this this kind of smart meter, right? So that is a Itron open way electricity smart meter with two-way communication for remote reading in US, used by DT Energy in US. Example is the newer retrofitted US domestic digital electricity meter Elster REX, right? That will use 900 megahertz frequency for the communication or for sending the data from the meter to the supplier, right? They will follow like these meters are connected in the mesh technology or mesh topology, mesh network topology, and that will do the automatic meter reading, right? So this is an example, okay? So this is about smart meter, right? The next is smart public safety. So so smart public safety, so from name you can understand it is about the public safety, right? So how you can use technology in your regular use which will provide more safety to the public, right? So that is about that thing, right? So so we have remain with three topic, right? So the smart public safety, smart security and surveillance, and smart sanitation, right? So the surveillance is also related like safety, right? Or for the security, and that we are using generally camera. So that is related to camera. And here in smart public safety, we can say like that the surveillance is a part of this. And in surveillance, we generally deal with the cameras, right? How you will put the camera, how you have to use the technology in whatever feed or whatever you get from that camera, right? And which that with that what technology you are using, so it will make your some of the tasks easy, right? So that is about smart surveillance, right? And in sanitation, sanitation will deal with like how make the public like healthy and provide them the hygienic environment, right? So that will see in the next lecture, that is tomorrow, right? So I'll finish here the lecture. I will share that Google link, right? Any question?